Today I'm comparing Modulify AI, Webflow AI, and Relume AI. To be fair, I'm gonna give them all the same prompts and then we're gonna see which one gives us the best results. I'm gonna be focusing on clean design, I want a responsive layout, and something that can be ready for production. Are you guys ready? Let's check them out. So first we're gonna see the prompt that we're gonna be using. So I prepared a prompt with ChatGPT, create a modern SaaS landing page for a productivity app, include hero features, testimony and pricing, focus on clean grid layout, balanced white space, strong typography and responsive design ready for production. Now we're gonna be using the same prompt on all the tools. We're gonna be going through their workflows and then see how they work. So first thing, we're going to copy the prompt and then go to Modulify. So Modulify is a tool that is an AI builder that builds design or layout sitemaps, and then you can copy those to Figma or Webflow easily through just copy paste. So let's give it a try. So first we're going to paste in the prompt here in the prompt box, and then you have the option of choosing a design or a layout or a preferred style. Now this is a nice mood board, like I like these styles, but I'm going to let the AI pick for me. So we're going to just let the AI pick. It's going to be in English. I like that they give you the options for a language, and then they have these extra tags that perhaps gives you a prompt. Okay, I see that it gives me an automatic prompt, but then we want to use our prompt, and then we're just going to paste it back here. Create a modern SaaS page for a productivity app. Great. And now we're going to generate, and let's see what Modulify makes for us. And it says, hold on, we're generating your site with AI. So while this is happening, let's go to the other tools and see what they generate. Let's go to Relume. Now, I made a couple of videos on Relume, so you guys can check them out. However, they have this AI site builder, which is really cool. And then you can prompt here, choose the number of pages you want, and then you get the sitemap right away. You get the wireframes, you get the style guide, and then you get some designs. So let's paste in our prompt here. We are choosing the least number of pages. So 1 to 5, I just need one page, but then we're going to generate it now. So as you can see, Relume first generates the sitemap and then gives you all the pages. Now I don't want these pages, so I'm going to just delete them. Delete, delete, delete. So we're just going to keep the home page with the sections that we asked for. And then we're going to go to wireframe, and then here it's going to start building. Now while this is building, we can go to Webflow AI. Here is Webflow AI. Now, when you start a new website, you get prompted to select a way to get started. You have this AI site builder, which is in beta right now, but we're going to be using it, checking it out. So we're going to be building for a business. The name of the business, let's call it Productivity Flow. And then we're going to paste in the prompt here. Tell us as much about the business as you can. This is where I paste in the prompt. And then we're going to go to next. And now here is going to review your site structure. So it's going to basically create a wireframe for me. So here we have navigation, hero section, logo, feature section. However, it's done. We're going to click next. We're going to see what's next. So now here as well, you have a brand style similar to Modulify, where you can create or choose the style that you like. However, again, we're going to let the AI choose for us. Primary site background, let the AI choose. Brand voice and tone, let the AI choose. Primary color, also let the AI choose. And then we're going to generate. And now this is generating. I like the UI. It's very nice. It's very, you know, it keeps you busy while it's generating. You can see some features. You can see this nice animation here and happening in the background. This is a very nice one. So now let's go back to Modulify. Let's see what it created for us. I see this boost your productivity app. It looks quite nice, actually. There is an email form. The site looks well organized, clean layout. There's some border shadows, pricing section. This one has no padding, which looks weird, but yeah, this section I think has no spacing or padding, which is not very convenient. And then we scroll down, everything else looks great. However, this section, perhaps we can always regenerate the component, see what we can do about this. However, again, we want to keep this fair, so we're not going to regenerate or do any edits. We're just going to go with the first prompt. And then now we're just going to take this. I'm going to take this website and add it to Webflow. So let's go back to Webflow. And what I need to do is add a new page. So webflow.com. And we're going to create a new site, a blank site this time. And we're going to call it Modulify AI site. Here's where I will paste in. So I'll just like Control V. I first need to copy this, copy page. So it's asking for selecting the fonts required. Next, how to paste in Webflow. Okay, so you just like really need to just control V here. And now it's syncing the classes. It built the site. Very nice. If I preview it, it has an animation. Oh, wow. Wow, this is super cool. There's intro animations. The section actually looks better here and doesn't look as bad. I think it's because of the screen size. The section looks much better here, properly spaced. This section as well. I like that they have this fade-in animations as you scroll, which can give the site a very nice experience. This was centered in the design. However, when I pasted it, it didn't get centered. I'm not sure why is that. However, this can be something minor. Now we're going to publish the site. I just want to publish it and see it in mobile version so we can test the responsiveness of it and how it performed there. So let's go on the site. Now I really like this animation, by the way. It's very nice. So let's go in mobile version. So I have this mobile simulator tool that allows me to see my site in mobile or in any different devices that I have. I'll leave a link to this tool below so you guys can check it out. However, this site looks actually quite responsive. It's quite nice. I like it. I like the responsiveness of it. It scrolls well. Again, you have this fade-in animations as you scroll. I like it. It's not bad. It's not bad. Could use some, you know, edits here and there. However, it's really neat for a first prompt for something we just did in a few seconds. Now let's see the other ones. All right, so next, let's see the Relume design. So Relume created a wireframe, and this is how the Relume workflow works. Again, sitemap. You see the sitemap, make sure everything is right. You go to wireframe, it creates the wireframe. Of course, you can always change, generate a new copy, randomize another shuffle component, similar to Modulify. However, again, we're not gonna shuffle anything. We're just gonna keep everything as it is. And this looks neat. So let's go to style guide. And here is where you can edit the styles of the site. You can choose the font, you can choose the button and forms, how they're shaped. Really cool, very nice options that you have. And then there is this new beta version, which is the design as per the style guide that you can directly copy into Webflow. So let's do that. Let's go again on Webflow and create a new site. New site, blank site. This one will be Relume AI site. Now in Relume, I'm not sure if this is going to allow me to just copy paste because it might tell me that it will need the style guide of Relume. Let's see. Oh, it actually did it. It actually just copied the wireframe version, not the design version, which I was hoping to copy. And let's try to debug this. So if I copy to Webflow, I'm prompted to get the style guide and install the Chrome extension. So let's do that. Copy to Webflow, clone style guide. Let's clone this Relume style guide and see. I'm going to create another site now. Relume AI site 2. And I already have the Chrome extension, so I'm set here. I'll just delete these and then we'll paste in what we got from Relume. Let's see if this time, okay, it's still giving me the wireframe version. I'm not sure how this works. Okay, so this doesn't work in copy paste mode like we thought it would, but we will need to get the Webflow app. So they have an app. Let's get the Relume app. We launch it. Let's launch this app. Okay, we have the launched app. This is the productivity page that we're building. And then now we can choose what do we want to import. We want to import the design, all pages, just one page. This is the concept start import. And now it's importing the design file. It's also editing the style guide, which is cool. But now it's working its magic. Now, while this is working its magic, let's jump back to Webflow and see what Webflow created with AI. All right, so this is the Webflow website. It's nice, it creates a logo for you, but I think this logo icon is used all the time. So it just changes the name for you, but it's not bad. Productivity simplified for team, an image section, logo section, well-designed, three cards, great. I like this. Oh, it's like a sticky cards stacking on top of each other, which is great. Four plans. It's not bad. It's image focused, very image focused, but it's really not bad. And now we can start building. and have this directly on our Webflow. Now, the great thing about building with the AI site builder is that you have the AI features where you can generate more layouts, you can generate different things, and this really helps you. However, you're still restrained within the AI site. But if you don't start the project with the AI site builder, you cannot do this. Another thing that is limited, which is you cannot transfer this project. So if you're building this for a client, I don't know how you can transfer it because it will not allow you. So if we check this one, productivity flow, we're not able to transfer it. It says transferring an AI-generated site to another workspace is not yet supported while in beta. So how useful is this? Depends on your workflow. However, if you can't transfer it, it might be limited to how much you can do with this. But the design, in my opinion, is pretty neat for one prompt. Again, one prompt go. We didn't even edit anything. Let's also publish this and check it in mobile version. So we go to the live version. Looks quite neat. Like, the only animation is the sticky section, and it's not really an animation, it's just a sticky section that where cards stuck on top of each other. Okay, it's pretty responsive. The logo section could be better with the grid of two. These cards are also stacking on mobile. There's some glitches which can be fixed. This section is not responsive at all. It's out of the container. The rest is looking okay. So I would say, like, this section really should be responsive. I don't know why it's like this. The rest is actually very, very responsive, which is great. Now, finally, let's go back to our final website, which is on Relume. So let's see what it copied for us. Okay, it's still working the magic. It could take up to 10 minutes. That's a bit of a long time for a site, for an AI generated site. However, we're gonna wait and see. While we wait for this, let's go and experiment on one more tool. This is a bonus tool, which is Lovable. Let's try to give the same prompt to Lovable. Let's see what Lovable creates for us of this website. So let's bring in the prompt, and I'm curious to see how Lovable works with the designing or making layouts that are responsive. So let's see what Lovable does for us. I like that it already named the tool. It's like Bloom Spark Showcase. It's a Bloom Spark tool. It's spinning up preview, and it's telling me what it's gonna do. I think Lovable is a way more advanced AI tool than the others. It covers more technology, it covers more details when it comes to building websites. It does not rely on Webflow like the others to host or publish the website, so you can just publish it directly in Lovable. Now, is this a competitor to the others? Not that much. However, I just wanted to add it as a bonus to see what we can do with Lovable and what we can do with these new AI tools when we create websites. All right, so we're waiting for this, and now we can just go back to Relume. Let's say import failed. Webflow is unresponsive or slow. Please check your internet connection. This is odd. Let's try again. Start import. I'm going to stay on this page just to like make sure it's loading well. Oh, so it does mention that. So it's stay in this tab. Leaving will stop your import. I cannot leave. I'm stuck here. So let's wait for this and see what it's going to generate. All right, we're done. It says 5 hours saved, even though we waited so long for this import. However, this is the site. It's done. It's ready. The logo thing is not done. How did it do the logo? Let's go back. I want to see. Okay, it's a default logo. Okay, so let's publish. Let's see how responsive this is on mobile and compare it to the others. So let's bring it up. So on the website, on the desktop version, it looks nice. Pretty basic, pretty simple. I like it. Oh, there's some animation on mobile, which is interesting. So this looks pretty responsive. Oh, the slider works, which is nice. Could use some padding here. However, it's nice. This section here, it's nice as well that you have this tabs that changes. I like it. I like it. Finally, let's go have a look at the Lovable website. So this is the version that Lovable built. You can see it's a very neat version, not much to it. Could use, like, it's not the best design tool out of the three, out of the four, but it's pretty simple. good for a first prompt. Let's see how responsive this is. So you can see with Lovable, I can publish directly. I don't have to copy paste to another platform. It does the whole thing within the same platform. So you just like publish. And now that it's published, you just shipped. Great. I copy the link. I can open it. This is the website. Very nice. Let's see the responsiveness. All right. So it's pretty responsive. No horizontal scrolling. So that's great. There is a huge padding on the sides, which is not very mobile friendly. However, it does look responsive. The menu is there. It works nicely. Yeah, not all aligned like it should, but it does look nice. So finally, let's compare these sites. So we have the Webflow productivity flow, and then I'm just gonna put them all in one tab. So you have Modulify site, I'm gonna get out of the mobile version. And then we have the Relume site, which we're gonna bring up here. So Relume. So we're gonna get out of the mobile version. Now you have these three sites, and I would love to hear your opinion on which site do you think is better or is the best. If you've tried any of these AI tools, I would love to hear your experience with it and what you guys use it for. However, I think, you know, we have some competition here, some nice tools. I think Modulify kicked this out of the park. Some minor problems here and there, but I think this is really nice. The scroll animation, things sliding in, fading in, something that the other tools did not do. This mobile thing I really, really like. I don't know if it's custom or it's just like a template thing that is always there. However, I really enjoy this website. I enjoy the experience on it. And then we have the productivity simplified for teams. So productivity flow from Webflow. This is pretty nice as well. Pretty neat, professional vibe to it. No much colors. It's this gray color is a bit like, okay, it's a default, you know, templated color. I like the green here on the buttons. However, again, these are all like, you know, seems like a template extraction or something like that. I'm not sure. And then you have the brand, which should have been productivity flow, but this always says brand. Whatever, whenever you generate it, this kind of looks the same. But yeah, this is nice. This is nice as well. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe, like it, and stay tuned on more videos, on more AI tools, on more Webflow related tools that we're going to be using. So see you in the next one.